Welcome back children. This is our 10th video for chapter 8, Economy and Occupation. And it will be, I think, our second last video before the question answers. Now, let's understand what is trade. So let's revise a little bit. Trade is buying and selling of goods at a given price. Okay, trade can be of three types. It can be local, it can be national, or it can be international. Now, local trade, which happens at local level, normally within a region, within a state. Okay, it does not really cross the state boundaries. Second is national trade, which happens within the country. So it does not cross the country's borders, but it can be interstates. It can cross the state boundaries. Okay, and the third type is called as the international trade, where the trade crosses the country's borders and goes to other countries. You can look at the lower picture here. Okay, that is a trade from one trade between two or more countries is called as international trade. This international trade can be of two types, or it includes imports and exports. Imports is when the goods enter the country, that is when we buy. When a country buys goods, that's import. And exports, when the country sells goods, that is it leaves the country, then it is called as exports. Now, let's understand what is balance of trade. Okay, that is the difference between the monetary money value of nations' exports and imports in a given period of time, generally within a year. Okay, normally 1 year is taken for calculating the balance of trade. And how do we get the balance of trade? By minusing exports from imports or imports from exports, depending on whichever is the higher value. Okay, if exports is higher, then export minus import. If import value is higher, then import minus export. That will give us balance of trade. This balance of trade is of three types: unfavorable, favorable, and balance. Let's understand what is meant by these three types, which you studied in standard 9. Okay, now when we say favorable balance of trade, now what can you see here is more exports, less imports. Now every country strives to increase their exports because they get foreign currency. Okay, and we have just studied that international trade happens in dollars, US dollars. Okay, so every country, when we export, we get valuable foreign currency rather than importing. So when our exports are more than the imports, we call it as favorable, and every country strives to get this favorable balance of trade. When do we say unfavorable balance of trade? Now here you look at the picture. The imports are heavier than the exports. That is, the import monetary value is more than the export monetary value. That becomes an unfavorable. No country wants an unfavorable trade. We all want our exports to be more than the imports. And lastly, balanced balance of trade. Now here you can see both the pans are equally balanced. That is, exports are equal. The monetary value of exports is equal to monetary value of imports. So both are equal. Let's understand this little activity that is given over there in your textbooks. Okay, where you have the... Just a minute. Okay, now what you have here is a table showing you the export-import balance of trade of India as well as Brazil. Okay, I have put the table one below the other, but in your textbook you have it side by side. I have left a little space to understand which of these is favorable and which of these is unfavorable. Now we need to keep our definition in mind. The moment you say exports are more than imports, it's favorable. If you find imports more than the export value, then you have to say it's unfavorable. Now, can we find out the first one? For favorable, I will put tick, and for unfavorable, I will put a cross. Okay, now the first one for India, 2009-10, we have 1,78,000. Here you have 2,88,000. So imports are more than export. So the first one is unfavorable. The second one, you find 2,51,000, and here 3 lakhs. Again, imports are more than exports, so unfavorable. third year 2011 and 12, 3 lakhs, and here it is 4 lakhs. So again, this is an unfavorable. Imports are more than exports. And the fourth one, you find 2 lakh 14 thousand, here you have 3 lakh 61 thousand. So again, imports are more. So all these are unfavorable. Let us look at Brazil now. Okay, Brazil, the first one is 1,52,000 export, and imports is 1,27,000. So this becomes favorable. For the next year, that is 2010-11, 1,97,000 export, 1,80,000. So again, export is more than import. Third one, 2,56,000, 2,26,000. Again, export is more than import. And the last one, I can't properly see here. I think it is 2 lakh. Just a minute. We'll try and get it together. 2,42,000 and 2,23,000. So again, this is exports are more than the imports. So this also becomes favorable trade. Okay, while for India, we found all are unfavorable trade. Okay, I hope this is clear. Now we come to the next a few questions that are given there. Okay, let's understand that in which country exports exceeds imports in all the years. Which country did you find? Yes, that was Brazil, where the trade was favorable. Export value was more than imports for all the given years. Brazil's balance of trade belongs to which type? So when exports are more than imports, okay, then yes, it is a favorable trade. Okay, and the last one, India's balance of trade belongs to which type? For India, imports were more than exports, and therefore India's trade is considered to be unfavorable. Okay, now remember, when we say exports are more than imports, we are talking about the monetary value, the value of exports and imports. So we stop here. In the next video, I will take in Brazil trade, Brazil's and India's trade comparatively, and probably that will be our last video for this chapter. So take care. God bless you.